Let's discuss about Goldleaf Electroscope. This is quite an old device which was invented to measure the amount of electric charge. It consists of a vacuum jar. It is like this. Let's see the physical situation of a Goldleaf Electroscope in which there is a metal rod. At the bottom of which there are two gold foils hanging, and at the top we connect a metal sphere. Now in this situation, when some charge is externally supplied to the metal sphere, say a positive charge is supplied to it, it will be distributed to the gold leaves, and as soon as positive charge is supplied, the leaves will repel each other and these gold leaves are having a tendency to move away from each other and their angle of tilt will increase. And we can say if more amount of charge is supplied, the angle of tilt of these gold leaves will be more. And if less amount of charge is supplied, the angle of tilt will be less. So this is the way how the relative measurement of charges were done in quite an old times. So we can execute many experiments on Goldleaf electroscope by using the phenomena. And to understand it better, let's discuss a physical situation. Here you can see this is a realistic view of a Goldleaf electroscope, in which there is a metal rod, there are two gold leaves and a metal sphere on the top of it. And say in this situation, if we bring a positively charged rod close to the metal sphere of this electroscope, we can see due to the positive charge we brought close, the metal sphere will get negatively charged because of induction, and the gold leaves will become positively charged and these will repel away from each other. Now if this positive rod is brought more closer to the sphere, you can see more electrons will flow from leaves to the sphere. So leaves will deflect more, and as the rod moves away, the deflection angle of leaves will be less because less induction will take place. Similarly, here you can see if a negatively charged rod is brought close to the sphere will become positively charged because electrons will flow towards the gold leaves. And in this situation, you can see the leaves will deflect away from each other. Similar to the previous situation, as rod is brought more closer, the deflection angle of leaves will be more because more induction will take place. Now say if we just touch the rod with the sphere, just see what will happen in this situation. Due to conduction, negative charge will flow from rod to the sphere. First, it will neutralize the charge on the sphere, due to which we can see the leaves will slightly come closer, and later on when it will become again negatively charged, you can see the leaves will again be deflected at a specific angle, and the water amount of charge is supplied to the metal sphere by conduction. Depending on that, or some kind of proportional relationship will exist, because of which we can see the deflection is more due to more charge. This is the way how a Goldleaf electroscope works.